My grandmother passed away last August, and it was a huge loss for the entire family. I think what floored me the most was how a person can be so much of a place. With my grandmother's death, I felt all the losses we've had before her, how in some way she held their space, and with her gone, the realization of time and how few of us were left was just heartbreaking. Death makes me grasp at the tangible, I guess because that person isn't physically here anymore. I flock to memories I can touch, quilts, chairs, photos, but then there's a surrender that it's not them and it won't ever be them again. This past Christmas, my papa gave me a box of negatives from the basement. A lot were his, shot on his Olympus OM-1 that I now shoot. But there was a little sleeve of antique negatives. When holding them to the light, I realized they were from his childhood. Photos of his parents, my great-grandmother, who I was very close with, and people I've only heard stories about and never met. We spent Christmas Day looking through them and talking as we try to navigate this new Christmas, a Christmas without my grandmother, who was for sure the heartbeat of the entire family. When I got home, I fished them out again and really went through them. Film is still very new to me, and I have just begun developing on my own. I sat there looking at them, thinking of the full process of photography. Then it hit me. This isn't a photo of my great-grandmother. This is her, her reflection of light, an actual tangible piece of that exact moment in my hands, developed and held in some strange backwards way. I remembered then the photos I took back in April 2022, right before my grandmother fell ill. I took them on my Yashica mat when I was really stumbling around my first truly manual camera. I found the negatives, held it to the light, and cried. It was the moment with her and my pawpaw outside their home, next to the chestnut tree that's been there since I was a girl, and long before. The negative buzzing with their love and their familiar comfort that their home had always brought me, and what I missed terribly. I remembered being told that when photography was new, people were afraid that cameras could steal a piece of your soul. Well, I don't think it's stolen, but there is some sort of essence that is left behind. These scans of these negatives, I feel them. I feel those people and those moments, and it's magic to me. It doesn't bring them back, but it reminds me that life is way more complex and infinite than I can ever imagine. That it isn't the end, and in some place, in some way, all those people are still here with us.
I'm going back to Virginia, and I expect to stay at my old Clinch Mountain home.
Carry me back to old Virginia, back to my Clinch Mountain home. Carry me back to old Virginia, back to my